sales, used car sales, and service customers, we saw a conversion rate of 12% in the month of September. That by itself is enough for me to say, I'm doing a pretty good job in paid search. That sounds wonderful, 12%. There are other folks, and I've heard recently some numbers that are twice this. Some people expect a conversion rate of twice this. I wish we could do that. Every vendor in here wants to provide 30%, right? That may not be the number that we can achieve, but 12% is certainly respectful. There's this other group of keywords, however, that can't be attributed to a specific profit center. And Brian actually said it just before I got up here. He said, your dealership name, that's where your traffic comes from. Right? We know that. We know that there's a massive amount of traffic on that dealership name. So we looked at just the dealership terms. We want to see how is it different when folks are just Googling your dealership, right? And we came up with 5 page views per visit, 5 calls per form. Why are there more page views per visit? They're starting on the homepage. Ooh. So a dealership term, like your dealership name, can't be deep linked to any specific profit center. Agree with me? Because it doesn't have anything to do with a product or a service. So these folks are landing on your homepage, and they're having to find their way to what's most relevant for them during that visit. Okay? The 5 calls per form, for me, that really shows the average between what we saw was a very high number for our service customers and the relatively lower number of 3-1 for our new and used car sales customers. They're meeting in the middle there over dealership terms. But again, the really interesting thing and where we started to draw some conclusions and where we started to be able to tell our story was when we looked at conversion rate on dealership name. That's a good looking number to me. All right? 18% of the folks who started their search with a dealership term that was not easily attributed to a profit center, turn into a lead. So we as a team, Alex Snyder and I, some other folks, sat down and we said, what does this really mean? What is the story here? There's got to be a reason. And we thought about the bicycle. Everybody talks about the bicycle, folks moving up and down from research to consideration. There's a purchase, hopefully, at the end of that tunnel.
Shows the value of branding.
We said, well,
the branding is what drives branded search.
Right? Maybe they're doing a building price, they're bouncing out, they're talking to their friends, they're looking at local results for ratings and reviews. They're considering service departments. They're making all of these decisions before they contact you because they don't necessarily want to talk to you, by the way. Right? Most of the customers we deal with today are the informed customer. They come with a purpose. So the story that we pulled out of here was, well, folks are doing all their work on our websites, they're looking around, they're leaving, they're talking to their family and friends, they're checking all the rating review sites, and when they come back, because they've been exposed to all of our marketing online and offline, they're just throwing our dealership name in that search bar. They're landing on our websites on